Yes, welcome to my fifth class of Laplace Transparam. Now I am going to discuss in this class furthermore trigonometric functions, how to find out Laplace transform. Now for example, first one is how to find out Laplace transform of cos square 2t. But we don't have any formula for squaring of trigonometric function, what we derived in the previous classes. Therefore, first try to simplify using fundamental trigonometric relation. You already know that cos square theta can be written as 1 plus cos 2 theta whole divided by 2. This formula we get from cos 2 theta. Instead of theta, what you have here, that implies cos square of 2t is nothing but 1 plus cos 4t divided by 2. Therefore, this cos square of 2t can be written as Laplace transform of 1 plus cos 4t divided by 2. Now, here we get two terms, but both the terms possible I to find out Laplace. If I will go for which property? Linear property. While taking linear property, I will keep constant means 1 by 2 outside Laplace transform of 1. And also 1 by 2 into Laplace transform of cos 4t. Now, which property now? Linear property. Most of you should have to mention the property after you use in the problem. Next, we know that before going to write that you write the formula Laplace transform of 1 is 1 by s, and also Laplace transform of cos 4t. What is Laplace transform of cos 4t here? S divided by s square, or if you want to write general formula for at plus a square. Therefore, this implies Laplace transform of cos square of 2t is nothing but Laplace transform of I'll keep 1 by 2 is a common in both the term, 1 by s. This is nothing but what actually? S divided by square 1 by a is 2, therefore 2 square is 4. This is a way to find out if you want to simplify with the 2, if you have interest to take LCM. But here they are asking fineness, nowhere to stop, also we get full marks. This is a way to find out Laplace transform. Suppose is having a squaring of the trigonometric function. Similarly, try for sine square 3t like that. Sine square can be written as, you already know that sine square theta can be written as 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Using this formula, you proceed it. The next second one is sine cube. I want to find out Laplace transform of sine cube 2t. Now you don't have a formula for 2b function of the trigonometric. Now I am going to use the formula for sin 3a. What is sin 3a? 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a. You already know that this formula sin cube a. From this, what is sin cube a here? How do we get sin cube a? You take 4 sin cube a the left hand side. Then 3 sin a. I shifted this left hand side down in the right hand side. What we get? Sin 3a. That implies what is my sin cube a here? Sin cube a is nothing but 3 by 4 sin a. Yes. Minus 1 by 4 sin 3a. Yeah. We know that the formula for Laplace of sin a t. Therefore, then I am going to express Laplace of sin cube t is nothing but Laplace transform of 3 by 4 sin, instead of a what you have? 2t. Sin 2t minus sin 2t minus 1 by 4 sin of, what is my a is? Here a is equal to 2t. Yes? 3 2s are 6, 6t. Now I am going to apply linear property of 3 by 4. Laplace transform of sin 2t minus 1 by 4 Laplace transform of sin 6t. Okay, fine. The next we are going to use the standard formula. We know that Laplace transform, what is the formula now? Sin a t. What is sin a t now? It's nothing but a by a square plus a square. Don't confuse hyperbolic sin a t and cos sin a t formula. Now 3 by 4 of, now what we get actually, a is 2, 2 divided by a square plus 2 square is 4, minus 1 by 4 Now what is area? 6. 6 divided by a square plus 36. This is a way to find out Laplace transform of cubic function. Instead of sine cube, if you want to take cos cube. Now you know what is cos dA formula. Cos dA is nothing but 4 cos cube A minus 3 cos A. Using this formula, try to find out what is cos cube A. Therefore, what is cos cube A we get now? Cos cube A is nothing but, I'll take this term in right hand side, we get 1 by 4 cos 3 A plus 3 by 4 cos A. Yeah. Using this formula, you proceed for cubic function for cos. This is a way to solve the problem for trigonometric function. To once you now see here also we are not using extraordinary up to till this step for up to the before applying the linear property we are going to consider what you already learnt in pure level. Therefore pure level whatever the topics are very important. Even though studying any further thing also then we are going to use any way any situation actually what are the things you learnt in first and second PUC. Therefore these other topics are very important. You refresh once again. Suppose you forgotten all the things is for my side opinion. Okay. Thank you very much for listening my talk. Now suppose if you are get happy with my talk, you please subscribe and give a like. Thank you very much once again.